Welcome everyone to today. It's certainly an exciting day for our YMCA of Central East Ontario. I would just like to acknowledge some of our political leaders that are here with us. We have leadership from our provincial government, from our federal government, and of course from our municipality, who without their support, we would not be here for this exciting celebration today. So just an overall thank you to all of our politicians who are with us this afternoon. Today marks a significant milestone in this journey called the YMCA Centre for Life. And oh, what a journey it has been so far. It was 5 years ago that we had the big idea, the idea of creating a centre that would not just be a YMCA, but with dedicated potential partners. We talked about what each of our organizations could be, our goals and desires on how coming together could assist us in building capacity, make all of our organizations stronger and more sustainable, and more importantly, we'll make magic happen where we could create together, serve more people, and have a greater impact on individuals and people throughout our region and change more lives. In the fall of 2019, I received a call from Minister Todd Smith, who said, "David, get an application for infrastructure funding in. You get this in, you submit it, and we'll support the project." We had the support of the federal government, we had the support of our municipal government, and in it went. Finally, in May of 2021, the announcement was officially made of $16.4 million from the federal and provincial government for the new YMCA Centre for Life.
Over the past 2 years, we've raised over $6 million. And it hasn't seemed easy at times, but it's there now, and we are there now. And it means that the project's gonna go ahead for sure. That's what it means. Thank you for being here to celebrate this significant achievement. We're now in a position, and while the job's not done yet, we're now in a position to go public in our campaign to raise the remaining $3 million to complete the YMCA Centre for Life community building campaign. The synergies are enormous. We are creating an inclusive centre that will open doors for more people in the community to become involved. Rehabilitation services, social support, work experience, and health and wellness programs will be available. It is estimated that the construction of the YMCA Centre for Life will directly and indirectly generate $30 million in economic activity and generate the equivalent of 200 full-time jobs over the length of the project. This is truly a legacy project for our community, so thank you all for your efforts and on behalf of that.
The mandate of the Parrott Foundation is to improve the quality of life of people in the Quinte area. And there's no question in the minds of our board that this facility, as we see the shovels go in the ground soon and we see it develop and build, will do that both physically, mentally, and socially. And we know that all of those things are needed to make a full life for all of us and as many as we can in our community. So I'm pleased to say, and it's already in Dave's bank account. Have you got it in there, Dave? Okay, all right. The Parrott Foundation have already made a contribution. And when people say to our board, "Well, you, Parrott Foundation makes grants," we say, "No, we don't make grants. We make investments in our community to improve the quality of life of the people in the community. It's an investment, and we all know what investments can do. The Parrott Foundation has made an investment in the new YMCA Centre for Life of $1 million.
So today we are going to unveil where we are sitting at to date. We've kind of let it out of the bag, but that's okay. You ready, Ed? Thank you to everyone here. Lyle, thank you for speaking. And that $1 million, of course, is significant to get us to where we are, but it is all of the significant donors and leadership donors that have helped us get there. And the journey is not over, and today marks another milestone of a chapter in our story. We're one step closer to reality, and because of all of you, I think we have a pretty good idea
of how this journey or this story will end. So thank you so much for attending today. Appreciate you taking the time. I hope you enjoyed your lunch. And I hope, and when I look around the room, one of the things that I noticed is we're not in the Center for Life. We're at 250 Sydney Street, but we are gathering with friends, and we are gathering with our friends and making new friends. So thank you for coming this afternoon. Enjoy the rest of your afternoon. Thank you so much.